Hello, I'm Mr. Aditya, retired lecturer in Hematology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is a continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And here I'm doing Gospel according to St. Matthew 22:34-40. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which we call in Punjabi Satguru, Jesus, according to St. Matthew 22:34-40. When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, now you know Pharisee and Sadducee was a division, and the division is between blind people. As for example, Islam means submission to the will of Allah, and not to the Allah's Son, the primary source of light. And not submission to the will of Mullah. Mullahs are moon and star. And that's why they have this division of Shia and Sunni. Because Allah is Noor. Noor means light. To light, Sharia doesn't apply. Sharia applies only to physical body. To moon. This is moon, the light of the sun to my heart. So that's the same way, you know, these Pharisees do say, they being blind guide of the blind, so they were divided. And this division caused sectarian riots, as in Northern Ireland, Catholic and Protestant. And they were called vipers, because they create strife between the people, division. When the Farsi heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together, and one of them, a scholar of the law, means like PhD in theology, as in Oxford universities are, men of letters, drunk with the old wine of the letters, tested him by asking teachers, but they only know teacher, but Jesus was a preacher. Which commandment in the law is the greatest? He said to him, you shall love the Lord of the creation, Yahweh. You know, Yahweh is jealous and revengeful. And he is Demiurge, he is the potter, this pot. This pot is tribal. Your Demiurge God, the potter, with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. That means first you become the son of man, and then you will become son of God. So, Yahweh is called Brahma in Punjabi, and in Arabic is called Khuda. So this is the serpent, you know, which Moses, strife between the tribes in blindness. Remember Moses in Egypt. He killed a soldier who killed a chosen person, slave chosen person. Because he was sick or something, and he had no mercy on him. So next day, Moses killed that soldier who killed the chosen person. And a few days after, he found two chosen people fighting with the arguing with each other and fighting. He tell them, oh brother, don't fight. You are brethren. You have one father, Abraham, and don't fight with each other. Then they said, who made you a judge? Get lost. So that fight is a serpent. And division among the people. If they are united under one father, Abraham, then they will be brethren and no more fight. Same way this father is. Abraham was a tribal father, father in flesh. Then we have, this is a father in flesh, and then we have father in soul, which is Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, the from where the soul come into our body. So that's the Most High. And in Jesus, we are the sons of the Most High. So when he took, Moses took them into the wilderness, over there he made them faithful to Abraham. That means they made them sons of one father. And then there was no fighting between them. They were united. And that snake was lifted up. So when it was lifted up, they were so faithful to Abraham. Then the same barren promised land became lush green. And after 6 days war, they went into the promised land. Moses stayed behind to stress that you need to be faithful to Abraham to live peacefully in your promised land. This promised land is Garden of Eden. Abraham is Adam. Sarah was Eve. So it was Adam and Eve living in the company of God when they are faithful to the Creator Yahweh. But if they are not faithful to Creator Yahweh who feed them this food, then they have no right to live in that land. And whenever they became unfaithful to Abraham, as the Jacob's 12 sons, 11 were crook, they wanted to kill Joseph for nothing, because he was a righteous person, salt of Abraham. While the 11 crook brothers, they have nothing in common with Abraham. So as soon as they sold Joseph as a slave to the Egyptian, and he left the promised land, they were none faithful to Abraham. So if Abraham was not happy, and so was Yahweh who brought them there. Yahweh stopped rain, and then Abraham kicked them out of the promised land. They had to go to Egypt as a slave. This story has been told by Jesus in the parable of prodigal son. Your father is Abraham, the elder son is Ishmael, and younger one Isaac and his people. So this was the tribal division of snake that made them weak. And then at the time of this Jesus, these Pharisees seducing, again was a division between them. And they were not united together. A division, some believe this one, some believe the other way. Blind guide defining an elephant. That's why Jesus called them blind guides of the blind. If they knew that there's one Yahweh, then he is God, and they worship him united, then Jesus need not come. But as they were blind, and they were creating blind disciples, so Jesus had to come, intervene. Then Jesus came to make us the sons of the Most High, which is greater than our tribal fathers. Remember in Kaaba, which is the temple of Adam, there used to be tribal gods called Illah. Illah means tribal, Illah means Kabila, and their tribal gods were there, about 365 or so. And Muhammad said, you know, that this is the time to worship Al-Illah, the Father, which is spiritual. So Allah is from Illah. Unless you are of Illah, you cannot be of Allah. Unless you are son of man, you cannot be son of God. So if you become the sons of the Most High, then the love you will have between you will be called Agape. agape divine love, which is far greater than the tribal love, which is called Eros. So then you have much greater unity and love in God if you know that you have one Father, God, or Allah, Parbrahm, or Elohim. The same thing, different names, different language, different meaning. So Yahweh, your demiurge God of nature, the potter, with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. That means first you become the son of man. Unless you are son of man, you cannot be son of God. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. Other means treat others as you wish to be treated, so that the snake that creates strife among the neighbors is kept away. The whole law and prophets depend on these two commandments. So the law and prophet is between to create love between tribal people, unity. Prophets are whip master for the rabbis, and rabbis are the moral teacher. They make them the sons of their tribal father. And the rabbis, they worship Yahweh, the creator of nature, who is jealous and revengeful. Whereas we in Jesus worship Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, which is the real and most high God. And we are made sons of that one. And we have, when we worship him, then we have no division between whether you are brown, black, or yellow in color. Skin doesn't matter, because it's the color of your soul that counts. And the soul has the same in a man and in a woman. So in Jesus, or in God, we are neither male nor female, nor Jew nor Gentile, nor Indian, Pakistani, English, German, nothing. We are one united in him, in souls, and we have a love called agape, divine love. That is why Paul said, you know, without love, I'm nothing. So without love, you haven't perceived our real Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, Supernatural Father. So when you perceive him, you hate none. And then when you think about his philosophy, or study the parables, and with Jesus has introduced our Father, then you develop a love called filial love, philosophical love, that is between the wise men dressed with Holy Ghost. And then you preach gospel from the rooftops. And if his Father is willing and has the happy with you, then he will lift you up from the seal to serve God, to put him under in his lap. When he puts you in his lap, you become a saint. As at Pentecost, our Father, you know, who was the owner of that vineyard, which was into which Jesus hired the 12 laborers to work on it. And when in the evening Father came, he asked the four men, Christ Jesus, present your laborers. And when he presented it, then he gifted them with the Holy Spirit, the capital S. So this is Trinity, once born, unlit lamp. That means they can't understand gospel. Nicodemus, Peter, belong to this part. Then twice born, Thomas, doubting. Newly, you know, newly have the Holy Spirit. So twice born, they are doubting, and Thomas went for money, and Judas Iscariot went for money, Mammon, he was a thief, and Thomas went for God. And these are those who are sealed to serve God. They listen and preach. They just listen. They put the light under bushel. They put the light on lampstand. They listen and preach gospel. And if Father is happy, he will take them from here to here. Very Holy Spirit, with capital S. At Pentecost, that's what they got as their reward for working with Jesus, working in the vineyard of our Father that has a narrow gate. Here is the picture of the vineyard. Here is the picture of the vineyard. It has a John the Baptist made them sons of man. He baptized the Jewish men in the name of Abraham, and Jesus in the name of his heavenly Father Yahweh. And this is the narrow gate for solitary. It is, has a kiln of his word. You have to pass through that kiln and then enter this royal vineyard. There, that's where Jesus made them to work. And here, you know, Peter, he was once born. He could not understand gospel, so he was the gatekeeper here. Anybody who told lies or anything, he won't let them in. Only people who speak the truth, they only appreciate the gospel truth delivered by Jesus. Those who are liars, they become hypocrites, and they are not, they work against the royal kingdom of God. They are antichrist. So Jesus died fighting the hypocrites, temple priest. John the Baptist died fighting the sinner, Herod marrying the wife of Philip, which was a sin against the law, transgression against the law, transgression against the Holy Spirit, caused antichrist. There are many things I can tell, but no customers, very few customers. Our Father God blesses you.